you want more, I'll give you more.
Welcome to the inaugural blind item of our Club Leo series. This is a long game type of blind item series. We're going to read every single Leonardo DiCaprio blind item that has ever existed since the 90s. And we are starting out in 1995 to 1998. I'm not sure which year. This is a Demi Moore Leonardo DiCaprio blind item. When that wacky aging sex pot and that youngish talented screw up were eating at a posh Beverly Hills watering hole recently, they managed to send every other diner into a tizzy. Seems the indiscreet couple was laughing hysterically, schmoozing nonstop and flirting to no end, but that's just the beginning. She later caused a sensation on her way out when she, completely unbeknownst to her guest, tried exiting without paying the tab and was caught at the door. Then, while waiting for the valet to round up her car, she slipped her startled dinner companion the tongue. That's not all. She did the same to the valet, to whom she passed her phone number before fleeing in her convertible without bothering to pay the parking fee or a tip. Her kooky, mortified friend covered them both with a $100 bill. Demi Moore and Leonardo DiCaprio. Do you think Leonardo DiCaprio was mortified at being described as kooky? You want more, I'll give you more. I had to do two Club Leo blind items today because it's our inaugural kickoff of this series. So we got to do more than one today. And this is a 1999 Leonardo DiCaprio blind item, which includes my second favorite Leonardo DiCaprio blind item rumor. The first one is about his rumored penchant for wearing headphones while doing the deed and crying at times. The other is that the man loves to roofie himself. Yes, that has been an ongoing theme, and here we have it first in 1999. This heartthrob made a splash in one of the biggest movies in Hollywood history. That would be Titanic. He celebrated stardom by turning into a party animal with a fondness for strippers. During a group session, a cuddle puddle, at a pal's mansion, he OD'd on the illegal party drug GHB. Paramedics hauled him to the hospital, but the incident was covered up since the party host is famous. Our guy didn't learn his lesson. Just weeks later, he visited another script club and became discombobulated from another night of GHB ODing. Pals fear it's only a matter of time before he's unalive from the drug. That blind item did not age well in terms of the fact that it is 24 years and Leonardo DiCaprio is still going strong with his penchant for groofying himself. Hey, at least he does it to himself. If I was Leonardo DiCaprio and I was on the set of Growing Pains, I would need to do that to myself too. We've all seen those behind the scenes. You want more? I'll give you more. Today's Club Leo Leonardo DiCaprio blind item is brought to you courtesy of the year 2000. Now, this is a special blind item because it says either Leonardo DiCaprio or George Clooney. It was one of them. And I know I have a lot of George Clooney blind item lovers here, so I wanted to do this collaboration. This handsome actor recently filmed a movie on location where the lovely local girls made themselves very available to the heartthrob. But one day, a grip walked behind the set and was shocked to see the actor passionately making out with a local teenage boy. The crew guy was terrified that he'd be fired if the star saw him, so he ran away. The grip kept quiet and kept his job, but now he's back home and boy is he talking. Now it says Leonardo DiCaprio, George Clooney. So it was one of those two. But just wanted to share this because the George Clooney rumors go way back. Our little confirmed bachelor. You want more? I'll give you more. Today's Club Leo blind item is brought to you by the year 2001. Now this is another one of those Club Leo blind items where it could be either Leonardo DiCaprio or, for this one, Tom Hanks. Johnny Depp, Billy Bob Thornton, George Clooney, Chris Knopf, Tim Allen, David Duchovny, and or Tobey Maguire. So it could be any, all of them, or just one of them, and one of them being Leonardo DiCaprio. Could it be that the star of an upcoming blockbuster has a little secret? Make that a big secret, and it's spreading like wildfire. During production, wardrobe caught him trying on another cast member's costume. Nothing wrong with that, except that the cast member was a female, and the costume was lingerie. Okay, that's a pretty good secret, but is it a big secret? I'm told that it's quite sizable when you're looking at it through the fishnet panties. And by the way, my sources tell me that this habit is something that the former TV star indulges in both on and off the set, which works out well since his partners are of both sexes. As much as I want to say that that's Leonardo DiCaprio, it's definitely Tom Hanks. You want more? I'll give you more. Today's look is courtesy of Tropical Storm Ophelia. And today's Club Leo blind item comes courtesy of the year 2001. Now, this is another one of those combination blind items where there are three different people mentioned. This one is special to me because it is either Leonardo DiCaprio, Edward Furlong, and I'm going to try and read this without crying, Brad Renfro. Literally my favorite childhood actor forever. After a summer filled with hardcore substance abuse and excessive behavior, this young and talented movie heartthrob finally got his act together. But that stint in rehab wasn't enough to keep him sober for long. The guy's no longer making scenes in clubs. Now he's smoking that thing that starts with a C and rhymes with back, and shooting H privately at home. But after one bitch word leaked out that he was so spaced out, he left a frantic message on his former rehab counselor's answering machine, asking the guy if he knew where he could score some more substances. Yikes. I think it's important to note the correlation between the substance abuse and all three of those men being rumored victims of CA in Hollywood. Rest in peace, Brad Renfro. I miss you so much. You want more? I'll give you more. Speaking of sitting across from Leo and Gisele Bündchen in 2002, today's Club Leo blind item is brought to you courtesy of the year 2002. And this is a Gisele Bündchen, Cameron Diaz, Leonardo DiCaprio blind item. I haven't showered since Friday. Shh. While a hottie actor was shacking up with his model girlfriend, he started having an affair with his then co-star. He told the actress that he couldn't break things off with his girlfriend because she was Lewis Lytle, which wasn't true. In the meantime, he was lying to his runway babe by saying that his co-star was an addict and he was only hanging out with her to help her stay sober long enough to finish the movie. And that movie is none other than the 2002 film starring Leonardo DiCaprio, Cameron Diaz, and Daniel Day-Lewis, Gangs of New York. Yes. You want more? I'll give you more. It's Yom Kippur today. That means God is judging me. But that also means I'm still judging you. We have the latest Club Leo blind item brought to you by the year 2002. This is another one of those. Is it Leonardo DiCaprio or Ben Affleck? It could be either or both. I'm going to go with both. This big screen hunk, who is in his late 20s, is a flasher. One of his beautiful leading ladies reveals that he gets so ripped while shooting their flick that he dropped his drawers and let it all hang out. The sad thing about it is that his private parts are, well, less than ample. And everyone who got a glimpse burst out laughing. But even that didn't stop Mr. Movie Star. He kept on flashing and flashing. Ben's like, let's get loud! Anyway, that sounds like it was Ben Affleck in 2002. Even though I have heard the same thing about Leonardo DiCaprio. Not about the flashing, just about the lack of endowment in his university. And by university, I mean what's in his pants. Achoo! Fuck. You want more? I'll give you more. Sneeze, that is. I'm super sneezy today, y'all. We have another day, so another Club Leo blind item. This one is, okay, every day I have a new favorite blind item. This is a Gisele Bündchen, Leonardo DiCaprio blind item. It's my new favorite blind item today, and it's from 2002. I never realized I had so much in common with supermodel Gisele Bündchen. My buddy is this great actor who could have any woman he wants. The one he has is a gorgeous model, but she's a bit of a nutcase. Literally same, minus the model part. He hates to be late, but she couldn't care less about time. Oh, same. When she came 2.5 hours late to my birthday party, he'd had enough. While he was reaming her out in front of everyone, she just casually tossed a drink all over the front of his pants and walked out. literally, I am Giselle Bundchen, she is me. We consoled him for the rest of the night and really thought their relationship was over for good this time. But just a week later, they were totally back together, screaming and yelling in public. Truth is, I think he likes her wacky behavior. Leonardo DiCaprio in Wolf of Wall Street, that was based on a true story. That was based on real life experience. He was method acting with Giselle Bundchen 12 years before that to prepare for that role. You want more? I'll give you more. By the way, this little treat right here is in regards to the Giselle Bundchen Leonardo DiCaprio blind item yesterday. Today's Club Leo blind item is brought to us by the year 2002, and it's another Cameron Diaz, Leonardo DiCaprio, Gangs of New York set blind item. Cameron Diaz was in her ginger era. That highly attractive charmer and that wildly sexy male movie star seemed like they'd be perfect for each other on screen. But they got along so poorly while making their new high-profile drama, he thought she was a humorless prima donna, and she thought there was nothing about him that a good bath, mouthwash, and better manners couldn't cure. Oh my god, I love Cameron Diaz. That they're far from convincing as mad for each other lover in the movie. The director apparently went berserk trying to come up with all sorts of tricks. Martin Scorsese was the director, by the way, to spice things up between his warring lovebirds, but nothing worked. Things got so rocky that by the end of the shoot, the co-stars wouldn't speak to each other or even sit next to each other off camera. We can't wait to see how they're going to attempt to fix this botch up in post-production. Spoiler alert, they fixed it up pretty well. You want more? I'll give you more. Today's Club Leo, Leonardo DiCaprio blind item, takes place in the year 2003. And this will be the third time you've heard someone say Leonardo DiCaprio needed a bath, because that's exactly what this blind item is saying. That ultra-hip Manhattan Hotel's cool staff has pretty much seen it all when it comes to wacky star behavior. But when a hard-living Hollywood hooligan shacked up at their posh hostelry for months, his shenanigans made even the blasé blush. For starters, he bellowed at the desk clerks when they didn't bring him adult videos fast enough. Then he dragged back to his suite a motley crew of trust fund brats and rent girls. What is a rent girl? Is that a horizontal professional? So many terms. The thing that got him banned from the hotel for life, though, was what he left behind. Lice. Okay, there's one little blind item after this one, and I'm going to share it because Lucas Haas and Tobey Maguire. Which one is this one referring to? What youngest actor, when he was at the frenzied peak of popularity, would tell available girls that they first had to do his male friend a very generous act toward the friend, if not the girls? And that says Leonardo DiCaprio. I bet it was Lucas Haas. Tobey Maguire could get it, I think. You want more? I'll give you more. Today's Club Leo, Leonardo DiCaprio blind item, is brought to us courtesy of the year 2003. And it's featuring polemic farting, which is my favorite pastime, personally. Wildly popular leading man has a habit of deliberately farting during love scenes. He loves to crack up the crew and to make his leading ladies uncomfortable. What is he, fucking 12? He's been known to waste loads of film playing this joke, but because he has girl appeal, and though not Mr. Blockbuster, he regularly brings in his target audience, so the directors and studio bosses tolerate his loutish behavior. That is loutish, not loudish, even though I'm sure it's loud. However, there are numerous leading ladies who loathe the idea of working with him again, but because of his image playing opposite him is so beneficial to their careers that nary a one would refuse, given a second chance. I have a feeling that that's what Cameron Diaz beefed about with Leo DiCaprio. She probably was like, nope. I feel like I read a blind item about Leonardo DiCaprio with a fart machine on the set of Gangs in New York, and Cameron Diaz absolutely not fucking having it. You want more? I'll give you more. Did you know every time a girl farts, an angel loses its wings? Or at least that's what Leonardo DiCaprio taught me. Speaking of Leonardo DiCaprio, today's Club Leo blind item is brought to us courtesy of the year 2004. What gives with that edgy, eccentric, and insanely well-paid actor? Years of movies and TV have made him so incredibly rich, he never has to work another day in his life if he doesn't damn well feel like it. He's always got an amazingly hot young thing clinging to his hunky arm, and they're still 25. In 2023, they're still 25. And career-wise, seems to be on top of the world, but yet waiters hate to see him walk into a restaurant because he tips as if he's down to his last dime. He dresses like a rag man, constantly clips newspaper coupons, and the rare times he shops, it's only at sales and thrift shops. Okay, there's no shame with that, as long as you're tipping your service members. Waitstaff? Did I just say tip your army? Although he lives in a fabulous old LA spread, most of the rooms are completely empty. His parsimonious ways have cost him more than a few friends and several famous girlfriends. Jeez, guy, cut loose with a buck once in a while, will ya? And spend it on me, Leo. That's the thing about Leonardo DiCaprio. He gets older and his 25-year-old girlfriends just stay the same age. You want more? I'll give you more. Every time a girl farts, an angel loses its wings. I can't believe Leonardo DiCaprio said that. Speaking of Leonardo DiCaprio, today's Club Leo blind item is brought to us courtesy of the year 2006. We have once again got Leonardo DiCaprio and Giselle Bündchen blind item. Their blind items are fucking insane. This next one is no exception. This handsome young actor had a beautiful longtime girlfriend, and they both started getting very successful in Hollywood around the same time. They seemed like old-fashioned sweethearts, but were far kinkier than we realized. They founded what they laughingly called the Hollywood Spanking Club. Okay. These private celebrity party get-togethers were actually cuddle puddles. And participants were encouraged to live out their wildest dreams. Alexa, play Wildest Dreams by Taylor Swift. Activities were fueled by an abundance of substances, of course. More often than not, our straight actor and his girlfriend ended up with partners of their own niche. The actor's motto was the difference between and straight is two runs down the mountain of skiing. a few years have passed and they both move on to new relationships. Both of their new partners would be very surprised to hear about the old days. Can you imagine Tom Brady like having any riz like that? He would probably cry. He would call Ben Affleck's nanny and be like, can you come over and just put on my Super Bowl rings again? I just want to look at them. All of my Super Bowl rings. You want more? I'll give you more. Definitely added to the list of best comments for this week is this annoyed mom's poetry. Lots of crying in the bedroom going on between Tom Brady and Leonardo DiCaprio. And speaking of Leonardo DiCaprio, today's Club Leo blind item is kind of sad. Trigger warning, Leonardo DiCaprio gets fat shamed, but it comes to us courtesy of the year 2007. The film being Revolutionary Road with Kate Winslet, filmed in Bethel, Connecticut. I guess in terms of the blind item, just focus on Leonardo DiCaprio's physique here. Could it be that a certain Hollywood heartthrob is battling an ever-expanding waistline? Sources on the set in New England tell us that the former hottie, who hasn't looked good since he cut his hair, okay, hair grows! Hair grows, except when you're Henry Cavill. That I'm never going to not see Argyle. Was called on the carpet by the studio brass. Good news, he's getting all meals catered in his trailer. Bad news, he's been banned from the craft services table and put on a strict diet. And the crew has been instructed to blab if they catch even a whiff or sniff of any verboten vittles. Yeah! Leo is weird and is problematic. Duh, 25-year-olds. But that makes me sad. That and the footage of the set of Growing Pains. Like, Leo been through it. And he's one of the celebrities I've actually met and spoken to. And he was like literally one of the nicest people because he just let me speak to him. And he bummed at least two of my seemingly cigs. You want more? I'll give you more. Oh my god, Tom Brady is getting lit up in the comments of my Club Leo Leonardo DiCaprio series. Don't stop, please. I love every day I wake up to look at the last Leonardo DiCaprio blind item and I see Tom Brady getting dragged for something else. You guys are the best. I love waking up to you. Lord knows I ain't waking up to anyone else. Today's Club Leo blind item is brought to us courtesy of the year 2007, and it's featuring Miss Vivica A. Fox. Some may argue this is a Vivica A. Fox blind item featuring Leonardo DiCaprio, but I loved it. This aging actress, that's kind of mean, by the way. Let's not do that. This not aging actress still has a thing for the actor Leonardo DiCaprio. Despite being older, she's been trying to get close to him for the last few years. They have crossed paths at several Hollywood functions. He acts as if she doesn't exist. When she heard he liked hip hop, she thought this was a sign for her to make another move. She told a mutual friend that she found him attractive and could the friend please relay the message. It's not known whether the friend did or didn't, but what is known is she got no response. This cougar has even attired herself in clothes appropriate for much younger women. Okay, and? Trying to catch Leo's eye. When she attended a premiere he was at, he ignored her, focusing all his attention on his girlfriend. Instead, once again, the plan backfired. Hopefully, she will stop making a fool out of herself and give up this obsession. Okay, now, I would like to just objection here, say that she's not the one making a fool out of herself with an obsession to give up. That's Leonardo DiCaprio dating 25-year-olds still. Like he was in 2007, and he still is today. Let's be honest here. Justice for Vivica A. Fox. If she's aging, I'm dead. I can't believe I no-showed to my own club Leo yesterday. I left you guys hanging without a blind item? I'm so sorry. I'll make sure that never happens again. Today's club Leo, Leonardo DiCaprio blind item, is brought to us courtesy of the year 2007. This one... I haven't even finished reading all of it because I just got to one sentence and I lost it. Lost my shit, literally and figuratively, and you'll learn why in a second. Well, it would certainly explain that grin. We hear a lot of sordid, dirty celebrity stories around these parts and very rarely believe them to be true. We like to give famies way more credit than they deserve. But when it came to the following tidbit, our source seems so earnest, so determined for us to believe. Well, we kind of believe it. So here goes. Which A-list Hollywood actor is well known among the dominatrix community for being a frequent client? Sure, he's linked with various model types, but in actuality, he'd much rather be tied up and whipped by some of New York's finest leather-clad doms. Julia Fox, what are you doing here? But that's not all. In addition to being treated like human garbage, he also enjoys eating human excrements. And go. Yes, that's how we put it. Yes, sometimes a shit-eating grin can be a literal term as well. That being said, we have a confession. We would I can't even read. Something about dropping trowel and dropping a pile. All right, you guys get it. Happy Friday.